Hello friends, welcome back to the video series on analysis of arches and cables. So in the previous videos we have seen sufficient number of numerical examples on how to solve the three-hinged parabolic arches. So many more such examples can be practiced by you, and you can just appreciate how the analysis of arches can be done. Now in this part of videos we will see how to analyze the cable structures. Cables are exactly reverse of arches, I can say, and we'll see how to analyze these cable structures. And once again I want to stress that we'll be only concentrating on the determinate structures, not on indeterminate structures. Now let us start with our cable structures. So you can see here the best example what I can give for a cable structure is a Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco, California, United States. You can see here this is the cable which is supporting this bridge deck. Now this bridge deck has been hanged to this cable using all these cord as suspenders. Okay, so this bridge deck, whatever load comes on this bridge deck, it will be taken care by these suspenders using the tension in the suspenders, and these tension will be actually, that load will be carried by these cables, and these cables in turn transfer the force to these pillars, and these pillars in turn will transfer the force to the foundation. So this is how a bridge cable suspended bridge deck can take the load. Now cables are often used in engineering structures for support and to transmit loads from one member to the another. When used to support suspension roofs or bridges, what we have seen in the previous diagram, and trolley wheels, cables form the main load carrying element in the structure. So in the force analysis of such systems, the weight of the cable itself may be neglected. However, when cables are used as a guys or radio antennas, electrical transmission lines and derricks, the cable weight may become an important and must be included in the structural analysis, right? Now two cases will be considered in these sections of the videos. They are the cable subjected to concentrated loads and cable subjected to distributed loads, provided these loadings are coplanar, that is the load and the cable are in the same plane with the cable. The requirements for the equilibrium are formulated in an identical manner. Now when deriving necessary relation between the force in the cable and its slope, we will make some assumptions that the cable is perfectly flexible and inextensible. Due to its flexibility, the cables offer no resistance to shear or bending. Therefore, the force acting in the cable is always tangent to the cable at points along its length, means the cable will not carry any shear or bending. Being inextensible, I mean to say the cable has constant length before and after the load is applied. So this is a very important part. As a result, once the load is applied, the geometry of the cable remains fixed and the cable or the segment of it can be treated as a rigid body. Now what I will do here is to explain how to find out the forces in the cable, something like that. We will use the numerical examples to exemplify that in a better way, so that it will be much more clear to you instead of making you to understand the concepts. So let us quickly just see here this one. So this is a cable which is subjected to loads P1 and P2. So this L1, L2 and L3, and the total span of the cable is known. So we actually need to find out what are the tension in these cables and what is the sag in the cable. Okay, given P1 and P2, L1, L2, L3, only these things are known to you. How can you find the tension in the cables and the reactions at the supports? So we'll see that using a numerical example, which I will just take up in the next video, right? So please do watch the next video. We'll see one numerical example to understand the analysis of cables in a much better way. Till then, thank you. Bye.